Hey guys, what is up and welcome back. As you guys can tell from the title of this video, and back by popular demand, I guess, today's going to be a little bit more of a laid back video because we are actually going to be doing a mental health video today. And the thing that I want to talk about is actually spurred from my recent video that I did about needing your guys' help. I could not put into words the outpouring of love that I got from you guys for that video. Honestly, it took me a while to get through all of the messages, to get through all of the comments. There's still a few that I haven't even responded to, but I have read because the outpouring of love was so semi-overwhelming to me that I just realized how much I love you guys, and that kind of spurred this video. I actually wanted to sit down and talk about the importance of finding your gang. So whether that be your girl gang, your guy gang, whatever it may be, finding a core group of friends to really love and support you, as well as getting rid of some of the toxic friends you might have in your life. Now, I have definitely had toxic friends in my life, and we're gonna get into all of this. I just really wanted to sit down and kind of give you guys a little bit of wisdom. I am almost 30 now, so I have been through my share of friends. I have had some friends that I've had for 20 plus years, some friends that I've only had for a few, and I just wanted to talk about the importance of finding people that kind of vibe with you, who find value in the things that you find value in, who find value in you, and I think it's a really important lesson. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started, and once again, I have a long as hell intro. I'm really, really sorry. So the first thing that I want to talk about is kind of how to go into this. Now, when it comes to finding your gang, you really need to think about what's important to you. Now, for me, the thing that is most important to me, obviously, is my mental health. I need to have friends that are able to understand if I am just not feeling okay. I have a core group of friends that if I'm just having a really bad mental health day, I don't need to come up with some kind of excuse on, you know, oh, I have this to do, or oh, I have this to do. I can just simply say, I'm not feeling well. My mental health is not doing well, and they understand because it is as important as something, you know, like a life event happening or, you know, work or something that you need to get done. And I have such a good group of friends that even if there's something that we absolutely 100% knew we were going to do, if I'm not feeling good, they don't hold me to it. Or even if there's like an obligation that we all have, if I don't feel good, I don't do it, and they understand. And it's so important to find somebody or find people in your life that agree with the most important things to you. So for me, it's always mental health. It's always finding somebody who really understands that sometimes I just need a day off from life. And a couple of other things you could consider are people who find value in your hobbies, whether that be reading. That's another thing that's super important to me. It can be finding somebody who kind of operates on the same wavelength as, you know, you're very family oriented, you're very like, wanna stay home, watch Netflix, just hang out, not really a fan of going out. It's important to find friends that really resonate with you for that as well. Another thing is maybe you like going out to concerts, maybe you like going out to the movies, maybe you like doing all these things. Finding friends that feel the same so that you're not feeling stressed to appease them and they're not feeling stressed to appease you. So finding people that are kind of in the same a life circumstance that you're in. A lot of my friends are either married or have children or, you know, are kind of a little bit older and sort of have some of the same values. And that's not to say that being like a teenager, you know, the things that are important to us are different from the things that were important to us when we were younger. And I think so it's important to find station in life, like where you are in life, and make sure that the people that you are finding are on the same station as you. Another thing that I think is really important when it comes to finding your gang is finding people that love and support you. It's easy to love someone, it's not so easy to support everything that they do. And I'm not saying that you need to support. If somebody's making a bad decision and you know that they're kind of making a bad decision, be honest with them about it. But I think it's important to find people who are happy for the things that you are happy for and are sad for the things that you are sad for. So if you've got this really great thing going on in your life, you're super proud of this something that you're doing, it's important to find people who love and support you and think that it is wonderful that you are doing those things. I have a core group of friends, there's about 5 or 6 people who, when I put up a video, they talk about it. When I am really excited and talking to them about a video that I want to film, they're really excited for me. And some of these people are even in BookTube. Some of these people are on Bookstagram with me, and no one is upset that somebody else is doing better. I think that a while ago, I put up a quote that said, it wasn't really a quote, it was just something that I was thinking of, that said, even if somebody's doing better than you, you can still be happy for that person and find happiness in their happiness. And I think that's incredibly important when it comes to friends, to find people who really are happy for the things that you are happy for. If you've got something really good going on in your life, it's really important that your friends be happy for you. They're congratulating you, they think that it's wonderful. I have a lot of friends who do things that I don't necessarily have the chance to do, and I'm really fucking happy for them. I think that it is great. I am so over this mentality, especially in like women-to-women communities, where we like to tear each other down. We like to compare ourselves to them. When you start comparing yourself to other people, it really takes all of the love and the connection out of a friendship. So I try not to compare myself at all to any of my friends. Everyone is completely different. A lot of the circumstances that people are put into is completely chance. So it's like, you can't really be upset with somebody for the good thing that is happening to them. It's all about chance, and it's all about loving and supporting your friends, even if you might be a tiny bit jealous, because I feel like jealousy is a normal reaction, but it's trying your hardest to love them despite that I think is the most important thing. And I think the more that you try to do that, the less jealous you'll be, and the more opportunities to make friends that you're going to have. Now I want to kind of get into getting rid of toxic friends, why it's important to get rid of toxic friends. I've had a couple of friends in my life who were going through difficult points, going through difficult times, and I was actually doing okay for once. And instead of being happy that I was doing okay, it seemed like they wanted to bring me down to their level. We've all kind of heard the quote, misery loves company. And if you have somebody in your life who isn't happy for the things that are going good for you because maybe they're jealous, or maybe they're at a really bad point in their life, it is okay and it is important to tell them, hey, like, I'm really happy for this thing that's happening for me, and I need you to be happy for me, or, you know, I need you to be a little less toxic, or it's okay to feel jealousy, but it's not okay to take it out on me. And if they can't get on board with that, because I feel like people kind of need to be told that they're making those kind of mistakes, that they are kind of being that way, I think it's very important to let somebody find the time to be aware of their decisions, or be aware of the way that they are acting. You need to kind of let them know. And I think it's important that once you've said that to them, if it takes a while, maybe like, I don't know, I don't even want to put a timestamp on it because it kind of depends on how severe the situation is. But if they can't get on board, if they can't get on board with loving and supporting you, they need to go. If they are the type of person who's making bad decisions pretty frequently, if they are making decisions you are uncomfortable with, like I mentioned earlier, if you are somebody who enjoys staying home and they want to go to the bar and they want to get drunk, like, there's nothing wrong with that. But if that's not where you are in your life, it's okay to kind of distance yourself from them. And I know it's incredibly hard, but it is really important, because you have to live with you. So if somebody's upset with you, that's okay, because they're not in your head. They're not you. So if you are pushing yourself to go uncomfortable circumstances, or you are feeling really down because someone's, you know, kind of berating you or being jealous of your achievements, it's okay to get rid of those people. And like I said, it's very hard to do, but it is something that I think people need to do more often. Obviously, that's not to say, like, I've had friends that I've been friends with for 20 some years, and they make really bad decisions pretty frequently. And thankfully, we have a lot of distance between us because they live in another state. But it's like, you still have to kind of figure out where your bottom line is, where kind of you cut things off. So if I have a friend who starts doing drugs and, you know, they aren't getting help, I have in the past cut quite a few people out of my life for that. And, you know, I wait for them to kind of come around. You know, I try to love and support them from a distance as much as I can. But really, if they've decided that's the kind of life they want to live, that obviously doesn't fit into my life. And I know that sounds kind of cruel, but you really need to put yourself first, even in friend situations. If somebody's making you uncomfortable, if they're making decisions you don't like, if their life kind of just doesn't align with yours, depending on the situation, you might need to go as severe as to say, hey, I can't hang out with you anymore ever again. I need to cut off all contact. Or hey, maybe we should hang out a little bit less, or only hang out in these kind of circumstances. Like I said, I know it's hard getting rid of friends like that, but unfortunately, sometimes it just needs to happen. All right, guys, so that is it for today's video. I'm gonna keep this really, really short. I have just been really wanting to sit down and just turn on the camera and film and not really take a whole lot of time to plan out what I'm gonna film. I had a bunch of videos planned this week and it just kind of all went out the window. I really just wanted to sit down and kind of talk to you guys. I'm feeling very connected again to the community, and that's kind of what spurred this, about the importance of finding your girl or guy gang. I think that it is really important. And I feel like when you do find that gang, you gain so much from it personally that no amount of words or no value can really be put on that. I couldn't explain to you how important it is for me to have the wonderful friends that I do have, and even having you guys as my subscribers. It's just so, so amazing. But that is it for today's video. That is my little chatty video. I'm just feeling extra chatty this week, but I hope you guys like this. Leave down below kind of how you decide who you want to be friends with, sort of, or even when you decide that maybe it's time to let someone go, and why you find value in your friend group, what your friends do to kind of love and support you. And I want to set like a precedence so people who may be struggling with friends can kind of see sort of where to start on building better friendships with people. But yeah, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and think about subscribing. But I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.